So before we celebrate the Mass, our first here in the Holy Land, we will have some moments to reflect as we are given some topics. Allow me to start reading from the book of Deuteronomy, the last chapter, 34. And let us imagine this written 3,000 years ago. And what has been written was about an event that took place right here. So it should give us a certain sense of hope and gratitude.
Father, could you have just 1 minute for Father Junio from the Franciscan monks who are in charge? He just wants to see, just say a few words to welcome you first.
Okay. How much time do we have? 3 hours?
Hello, Father.
Hello.
Welcome to Mount Nebo, and we are happy with your visit. And also, we are lucky because we just reopened the Basilica 2 weeks ago.
October 16th.
Yes. Yeah. Then also, this experience here is new. Okay? Well, here, actually, the stone we're not using because we have some problems we need to organize. I ask you, we can stay, but in this, in the...
Down.
Yes, down. Sorry to disturb you.
Yeah.
No problem. But then... Welcome to Mount Nebo, and have a good celebration. And pray for us,
okay.
Pray also for the Christians in the Middle East.
Thank you.
Well.
Thank you. Yeah. So there are two reasons why I'm speaking for you right now. One is to allow that to be observed. And the second is anyway, let me continue reading from the book of Deuteronomy chapter 34. Then Moses went up from the plains of Moab to Mount Nebo at the top of Pisgah, which is across from Jericho. And the Lord showed him all the land of Gilead as far as Dan, all Naphtali in the land of Ephraim and Manasseh, all the land of Judah as far as the western sea, the south, and the plain of the valley of Jericho, the city of palm trees, as far as Zoar. Then the Lord said to him, this is the land which I swore to give Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, saying, I will give it to your descendants. I have caused you to see it with your eyes, but you shall not cross over. So Moses, the servant of the Lord, died there in the land of Moab, according to the word of the Lord. And he buried him in a valley in the land of Moab, opposite Beth Peor. But no one knows his grave to this day. Moses was 120 years old when he died. Well, my dear brothers, our coming here should actually be ideally the beginning of our pilgrimage, no? It's not the other way around. But because of inconvenience, we needed to visit first the River of Jordan. But in a way, everything started here, no? Because when Moses saw the promised land, but it was only for him, for his eyes only, no? And I was just surprised that Moses did not complain. Can you imagine, he worked so hard. In fact, he wasn't expecting this kind of mission. He was just pasturing the sheep of his father, father-in-law, Jethro, as we read from the book of Exodus. No? Then all of a sudden, he heard a voice saying, Moses, Moses, remove the sandals from your feet, for the place where you are standing is the holy ground. And that was the calling of Moses. And so, from that time on, he was completely changed. From a shepherd to a leader of people. He will be a liberator in some sense. And he had some doubts, just like Mary, the Annunciation. But there was a very assuring voice of God. I will be with you. And if we read the Old Testament, Testament down to the New Testament, that's always the case, no? Whenever there is a calling, there's always an assurance, I will lead you. Now, I believe all these words, this event, should resonate in the heart of every priest, like me and my friends. Because like Moses, we've been called. And he was called with a name, Moses, no? Must have been special. He wasn't really the best. In fact, he had some complaints. He said, I don't know how to speak. Anyway, don't worry. I'll give you somebody to assist you, no? Like a sort of vicar parade or something like that, no? Assisting us, no? Now, the point here is this. What do we see in Moses? The one who saw the promised land but not given the privilege, so to say, to walk on it, though he had worked so hard, many times, that is also our own experience. I'm now 37 years in the priesthood, and sometimes I'm also looking for the fruits of what I have done. And probably in this event, as we are sitting here reflecting on what happened to Moses, it's also reminding to all of us that all we have to do is just to be resigned to the mission given to us. And so we should not complain. And much less not to invoke a certain kind of entitlement, no? He could actually have complained to the Lord and say, Yahweh, you know me. You just called me out of the blue. And then you made me lead these people, in some sense, are so hard-headed. And many times he had encountered so many difficulties, no? But Moses just resigned himself, no? So for us, I believe the jump from the promise to the future can actually take place if we are men and women, actually. There are some women here with us as well, though lay people. We can participate in bringing to reality the future, the promise becoming a reality, if we are like an instrument that is faithful to the one who asked us for that mission. Siguro, it will be nice to think, at this point in time, we have been called, we have been ordained. Is there still that kind of disposition in us, no? Of readiness at whatever cost, no? Because what happens sometimes, and I include myself, no? All the years that we become priests, we feel we have worked so hard, and therefore we deserve some reward, no? And some entitlement, no? When we were seminarists, we were so simple. The rector would just send us here and there, and we would not complain. Na maging pali na tayo, nakatikim na magandang parokya. Bishop, you can no longer bring me to a poor parish. I'm not used anymore. It happens. And that is sad. That is sad because the mission of Christ will not be fulfilled. And what happens is we have our own mission. We have our own task. It's no longer the work of God, but our work. So the promise remains a promise. Sabi nga sa Tagalog, pangabong napapako. No. But like Moses, let us be instrument of liberation. And I believe the liberation should start inside us. The liberation in our hearts, liberation from our self-centeredness, liberation from our own pride, liberation from our own sense of entitlement. And Pope Francis has always been hitting hard on that. Because it's rather clear on him that one of the obstacles by which we find ourselves difficult to fulfill the mission entrusted to us. It's when we now look at ourselves rather than look at the mission. Moses gazed on the promised land, and then after that he died. No complaint, nothing. He resigned completely. As if he was telling himself, at age 120, I have done what I should be doing. I am just useless servant. And that would actually come from Jesus himself telling his disciples. And so, my dear brothers and sisters in Christ, let this celebration of the Eucharist be a moment for us to ask for this particular grace. We had the renewal of baptism. I believe this is the best moment to renew our own priesthood, especially the spirit of service that we should carry, much like Moses, the liberator. I just would like to add some notes, as this is the first conference of our retreat. Three words, so that we can make this pilgrimage retreat a meaningful and fruitful one. Because we have planned out for this a long time ago. Mutik pa nga ito na mobilyaso, hindi pa natin thesis that this is possible. And this is in connection with our Golden Jubilee. So in a way, it will be nice to really make this retreat a golden one, something that is memorable and something that is fruitful. I think three things will be required of us. First is a prayerful attitude. Prayerful attitude would mean the places that we will be visiting, we should have that kind of spirit in us, that we are conversing with God. We have been preaching about this, and here we are now, seeing, touching history 3,000 years ago. So this is a real privilege. So there is a big difference between being a tourist and a pilgrim. A pilgrim is somebody is always prayerful during the time of journey. A tourist is busy taking pictures. I'm not saying taking pictures is bad, but side by side with taking pictures, and I suppose you'll be happy to share them with your parishioners, we have some moments of silence, to be alone with God. And Saint Jose Maria Escriba as a beautiful reminder for us when we read the Gospel, and that is to imagine ourselves as one of the participants in a particular scene of the Gospel. In this time, I would like to imagine looking at Moses, who was very old already, although according to the scripture, to the last day, he was very strong, and he had a very clear vision. Hindi siya nakailangan ng salamin whatsoever. And he saw from afar the promised land. And makikita natin doon si Moses nakatingala. Ako siguro, I would imagine myself nakatingin sa kanya para ako din ay napalalahanan. Lagi tayong tumingala sa itaas. In the letter of St. Paul to the Colossians, we'll be reminded of that as well. Seek the things of heaven, Christ is reigning with the Father. It can happen in our priesthood that we're always looking down because there are so heavy burden that we carry. Not so much the work, but the languages of our own capricious attitude and sense of entitlement. Kanina sabi ko nga, as we were walking, going to the River of Jordan, I was even jumping, I had no difficulty moving around. Pagkatapos ng heavy lunch, coming here was a big ordeal. Reminding us, pag tayo maraming luggage sa buhay, throwing them away so that the essential things would remain in us, not the incidental things that are so attractive so because they are so colorful. And secondly is a sense of gratitude. You know? So coming here, we'll have to be thankful to the Lord for the gift of faith. Otherwise, there's no point for us coming here. What would be the meaning of that murky water of the Jordan River, no? Wala eh. Pero kanina, as I was there, even though the water is not so attractive, but I feel I would like to dip myself, but it wasn't allowed, no? Why? Because I am grateful for the gift of faith and baptism that I received. Now, because I am, lagi nga sinasabi ni Bishop, mga anak tayo ng Diyos because of that. And lastly, is not only a sense of gratitude, but I guess we should have a spirit of hope in us, no? That the fighting sometimes can be so very hard, fighting ourselves and fighting forces around us. But there is always that assurance that God will be with us. So it's worth the pain, it's worth the all the efforts that we put into fighting ourselves, because at the end of the day, we will be able to reach the promised land. Actually, naman tayo ni Moses. Siya hindi nakapunta roon, nakita lang niya, tayo, with the facility of transportation from here to Mount Nebo, will be going down and we will be walking where the Lord Jesus walked 2,000 years ago. We were so privileged than Moses. So Moses must have been looking with envy. But no, I immediately hasten to say, because during the transfiguration, Moses was there. Kaya lang, hindi na siguro yung kanya katawang lupa, yung kaluluwa ni Moses ang nando. Because the three disciples who were with Jesus, no? James, John, and Peter, saw Elijah and Moses with Jesus. Well, so finally, Moses was able to reach the promised land. And indeed, yes, because Moses is now with God in heaven. Because for us, the promised land is not so much the physical thing that we will reach one day, but it is our homeland. I hope magkasama-sama tayo doon as we are together now in this big place.
Please rise and let us sing the opening hymn.
Purihin ang Panginoon, umawit ng kagalakan, patutuin ang mitad.
Prepared by the Franciscan be celebrating for the first time Mass in this Franciscan monastery. So as we begin our celebration, for us first timer and maybe a common impression of all of us, that our faith has a very humble beginning. Kaya sa tayo tumingin, napaka-harsh ng buhay na tinahak ng ating Panginoong Jesucristo at ng kanyang mga apostol. Napaka-humble ng pasimula ng ating pananampalataya. Kaya naman, hingin natin ang patawaran marahil naging malabis tayo sa ating pamumuhay bilang tagapagpatuloy ng pananampalatayang ito. Sabi nga ni Papa Francisco, if we take away the poor, then we can never understand the gospel. Let us be sorry for the sins that we have committed against that virtue of poverty, against that virtue of sharing in the sacrifice of Christ for the salvation of the world. Altogether, I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have received my might in my words, in what I have done and what I will do, through my fault. Therefore, I ask as Mary, the Virgin, holy in His name, and you, my brothers and sisters, pray for me, O Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, through Moses, you freed the chosen people from the slavery of Egypt and gave them your holy law, free from the slavery of sin through the faithful observance of your commandments. May we arrive at our heavenly fatherland, O Lord Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Reading from the book of Exodus. Meanwhile, Moses was tending the flock of his father-in-law Jethro, the priest of Midian, leading the flock beyond the wilderness. He came to the mountain of God, Horeb. There the angel of the Lord appeared to him as a fire flaming out of a bush. When he looked, although the bush was on fire, it was not being consumed. So Moses decided, I must turn aside to look at this remarkable sight. Why does the bush not burn up? When the Lord saw that he had turned aside and looked, God called out to him from the bush, Moses, Moses. He answered, Here I am. God said, Do not come near. Remove your sandals from your feet, for the place where you stand is a holy ground. I am the God of your father, he continued, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob. Moses hid his face, for he was afraid to look at God. But the Lord said, I have witnessed the affliction of my people in Egypt, and have heard their cry against their taskmaster. So I know well what they are suffering. Therefore I have come down to rescue them from the power of the Egyptians, and lead them up from the land into a good and spacious land, a land flowing with milk and honey, the country of the Canaanites, the Hittites, the Amorites, the Perizzites, and the Girgashites, the Hivites, and the Jebusites. Now indeed the outcry of the Israelites has reached me, and I have seen how the Egyptians are oppressing them. Now go. I am sending you to Pharaoh to bring my people, the Israelites, out of Egypt. But Moses said to God, Who am I that I should go to the Pharaoh and bring the Israelites out of Egypt? God answered, I will be with you, and this will be your sign that I have sent you. When you have brought the people out of Egypt, you will serve God at this mountain. But, said Moses to God, if I go to the Israelites and say to them, the God of your ancestors has sent me to you, and they ask me, what is his name? What do I tell them? God replied to Moses, I am who I am. Then he added, this is what you will tell the Israelites. I am has sent you to me, has sent me to you. God spoke further to Moses. This is what you will say to the Israelites. The Lord, the God of your ancestors, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob has sent me to you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Holy is the Lord our God.
Holy is the Lord our God.
Exalt the Lord our God, bow down before his footstool. Holy is he. Response.
Holy is the Lord our God.
Moses and Aaron were among his priests, Samuel among those who called on his name. They called out on the Lord, and he answered them. Response.
Holy is the Lord our God.
From the pillar of cloud, he spoke to them. They kept his decrees, the law he had given them. Response.
Holy is the Lord our God.
O Lord our God, you answered them. You were a forgiving God to them, though you punish their offenses. Response.
Holy is the Lord our God.
Exalt the Lord our God, bow down before his holy mountain. Holy is the Lord our God. Response.
Holy is the Lord our God.
Please all rise. Alleluia, alleluia. I will sing to the Lord, for he is graciously triumphant. Horse and chariot he has cast into the sea. Alleluia, alleluia.
Alleluia, alleluia.
Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
After 6 days, Jesus took Peter, James, and John, his brother, and led them up a high mountain by themselves. And he was transfigured before them. His face shone like the sun, and his clothes became white as light. And behold, Moses and Elijah appeared to them, conversing with him. Then Peter said to Jesus and replied, Lord, it is good that we are here. If you wish, I will make 3 tents here, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah. While he was still speaking, behold, a bright cloud cast a shadow over them. Then from the cloud came a voice that said, This is my beloved Son, with whom I am well pleased. Listen to him. When the disciples heard this, they fell prostrate and were very much afraid. But Jesus came and touched them, saying, Rise, and do not be afraid. And when the disciples raised their eyes, they saw no one else but Jesus alone. As they were coming down from the mountain, Jesus charged them, Do not tell the vision to anyone until the Son of Man has been raised from the dead. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good afternoon, everybody.
Good afternoon.
Kanina po talagang hindi ko na malaman kung anong naramdaman ko kung saan ako punta. Kasi kanina ko lang nalaman na akong homilist ngayon. Kanina umaga. Kaya dun sa airport gusto ko nang bumalik sa Pilipinas. and lalo ngayon, kinabahan na naman ako because I have prepared my homily with the gospel, no? The gospel for today. With this special gospel, Lord. Anyway, well, again,
I think it's God's plan.
Well, according to our gospel, the regular gospel for today, well, there are three powerful negative attitudes and feelings that emanate in us and in many times conquer us. First, fear. Second, insecurity. And third, anger. These three negative attitudes and feelings don't only conquer us, but at most enslave us. These were the same feelings that the blind man in our gospel felt, the feeling that made the man lonely, the feeling that molded his heart to be irritable and selfish, until he was able to meet the light, the reality of truth, and the openness of a loving heart in the person of Jesus. It is through the openness of meeting with Jesus that made him to completely allow Jesus to be with him, to allow Jesus to manage his life, and allow Jesus to be his complete light that make him able to appreciate and to accept, and of course to be completely his companion. My dear brothers, we are all here with these questions in our lives and in our heart that is being conquered by anger and selfishness. We are here not only to go through some adventures, to experience with an awe and wonder, not only to travel in a foreign land, but at most, we are all here to experience God's unquestionable love and care. Blind as we are, we all hope that Jesus will never leave us insecure. He will never allow us to walk amidst darkness and will never leave us untouched with his wonderful hands and heart, the living symbol of his love.
Without entering it, we pray to the Lord through the intercession of the saint who led Israel from slavery to liberty. Lead us from servitude to the glory of the children of God. Let us pray together and say, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Prophet has arisen in Israel like Moses, whom the Lord moved face to face. That the Lord will raise up also in our time men of God and prophets who can be a reflection of his gaze of love and mercy toward our brethren. Let us pray to the Lord. Moses and Aaron were among his priests. Samuel among those who called on his name, they called on the Lord and answered them. That the Lord may give us the same spirit of faith as Moses and other biblical personages, so that our prayer will always reach the heart of God and be heard by him. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God said to Moses, I am who I am. Because the Lord revealed himself to Moses as always being close to those who call on him, may we always feel his consoling and salvific presence. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
He made known his ways to Moses, to the Israelites, his deeds. Because the Lord revealed to the holy patriarch the ways of his mercy and loving kindness, slow to anger and abounding in mercy, that we may have an acute sense of his love for us, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Moses was faithful in all his house of God. That the Lord who found in Moses a servant worthy of trust may find us too. worthy servants of his will in every circumstance of his life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Lord, who chose to confirm the mission of his Son on Mount Tabor with the witness of the law and the prophets, grant a sincere love of Holy Scripture, and that we may also find in Christ the accomplishment of all revelation. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Lord, who through Moses announced salvation that would be accomplished in the gift of the Son raised up on the cross, always turn our gaze toward the crucified Savior, so that through our faith in him we may obtain healing from the bites of ancient serpent. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
As a presbyterium of our diocese, making our annual retreat in this holy land, we deeply pray for our common intention for the celebration of our diocese of our Golden Jubilee. We pray for fruitful, holy, and relevant celebration of this Golden Jubilee of our Diocese of San Pablo. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, you who brought to this place to celebrate the joy of liberation from servitude and the beauty of freely chosen commitment, grant us to listen anew and to renew our faith in the gospel through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
And so with the angels and archangels And with the great multitude of the saints, we sing the hymn of your praise as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of all hearts, heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the bond of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body which is given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the deliverer, the covenant, which will be put up for you and for men for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
Christ has died, Christ has risen, Christ will come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and chalice of salvation, giving thanks as we have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, the Bishop of this diocese, and Benaventura, our Bishop, and all the clergy.
Remember also, brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, with him,
and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen.
Amen.
from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever."
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also your spirit.
Thank you.